Okay, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to do an ink blot effect, also known as an instant painting effect, also known as a dynamic reveal effect in After Effects. So the first thing you need to do is go online and either Google or Bing, it doesn't matter, get a paper texture, literally type that in, paper texture, and get the highest resolution you possibly can. When getting basically stock photos off the internet, I always recommend you get the highest resolution you possibly can. It's really nothing in After Effects to bring that resolution down to match certain subject matter, but it is next to impossible to bring it the resolution up. But by far the most important thing you need for this effect is called an ink blot graphic. It's usually a white backdrop with black ink soaking into a surface. Now, these are not fantastically difficult to find. You can get them with screen capture. You can download them if you wish, but it's really not necessary. The most common mistake that people make with this effect is that they don't realize that the, in this case, the white part of the graphic needs to cover the picture behind it. It does. If you don't, it will actually reveal what you want before you want, and it will look just like crap. So basically what this effect is, everything on the ink graphic that is in white will be simply invisible. And everything that is in black on the ink graphic is going to reveal the picture behind it. Now, this was a screen capture effect that I got off the internet. It doesn't do exactly what I want it to do. So what I'm going to have to do is use just some very basic positioning, just moving the image around. It will not cover the entire screen like I need it to. So I'm going to click down here to this little box. That turns it into a 3D object in the computer, which means I can move it forward and backwards, not just side to side. And I've got my timeline set up. Have it end right here. And then I'm just going to move it progressively closer. Remember, negative numbers bring the image closer to you in the 3D effect. Now it's covered in black. And that's my timeline. I've gone from completely white to completely black. So now at this point, it's actually going to start to, you know, actually look like something. Go down here where it says none, right on the object where basically the image that you want to see, not on the ink effect. Left click on the word none, then click on, it's the bottom option, Luma Inverted Matte. And now the image of the river is appearing over the paper. So if you just wanted to do the one image, you are basically done at this point. But I always like to have a background and foreground to truly customize an image. So I've got this picture of my sister just before she was awarded Miss Congeniality. And clearly this was already a green screened out, so just go to key light, and then click on the green to basically just turn it into a green screen effect. So now you just repeat the whole process over again. You're just doing to the foreground what you just did to the background. Just remember to keep everything in order. One ink graphic per layer, and that ink graphic is only going to affect the layer that is directly beneath it. So now that the effect itself is effectively done, both background and foreground, now it's time to actually make it look good. In my opinion, this effect just looks a lot better in black and white. It's obviously works in color just fine, but my artistic mentality, I like to make it go black and white. To take something from color to black and white is one of the easiest things to do. Just go to Effects, Color Correction, Black and White. Then repeat the same thing to the background. So at this point, they're both in black and white. I can clearly see that her image is quite a bit darker than the background. It's actually a pretty easy fix. Just go up to color correction, brightness and contrast, and they're just going to turn the brightness up on her until I basically feel like they match. And just for the fun of it, I'm going to add another foreground. Exactly the same process as before. I'm just going to add some zombies. Why not add zombies? There's always room for more zombies. And that's how this effect is done. It's a fun graphic. It's got, just like everything else in After Effects, almost limitless possibilities. And thanks for watching.